Hello, welcome to World News Today. Click the like button for this video, and if you are new, click the subscribe button and enable notifications to stay up to date. Thank you. Canada's open-door immigration backfired. Now they want one favor from Trump. Canadian Prime Minister Justin Trudeau previously criticized President Donald Trump for his executive order limiting travel from hostile countries. Now that Canada's open-door immigration policy has backfired, they're begging Trump for one huge favor. According to the New York Times, Trudeau railed against Trump in January 2017 for his efforts to secure our country's borders and limit the amount of travel from known Islamic terrorist farms around the world. Trudeau jumped on social media to tell the world that Canada would gladly accept immigrants who are shut out by the United States. To those fleeing persecution, terror and war, Canadians will welcome you, regardless of your faith. Diversity is our strength. Welcome at Okanada, Trudeau wrote. Now, the Washington Post reports that Canadians are not just having second thoughts about their disastrous open-door immigration policies, but in fact are asking the Trump administration to stop some immigrants from being able to enter the United States so that they will not migrate into Canada. That's right, Canada's freaking out after a flood of Nigerian immigrants have made their way across a ditch in upstate New York. Now that there are too many Nigerians in Canada, our northern neighbor is asking the U.S. for help. Canada is reportedly asking our government to reduce foot traffic by screening Nigerians more stringently before allowing them to obtain U.S. visas. The influx of immigrants into Canada caught their government by surprise in the summer of 2017 when people, mostly Haitians, began to truck into Quebec via an irregular border crossing north of Plattsburgh, New York. Where all bleeding heart Canadians who pushed for open borders now. Now that spring is here, the flow of immigrants into Canada is speeding up again. Much to Canada's dismay, the majority of asylum seekers have been Nigerian, and their chosen route into the north is more problematic, Canadian officials say. A spokesman for Canada's immigration minister named Matthew Jenness said that many Haitians had lived in the United States for years before suddenly finding out that they would lose their protected status and be deported. This resulted in many of them fleeing north across the Canadian border. Most recently, an overabundance of Nigerian immigrants have been arriving in Quebec with recently issued U.S. visitor visas. They're not using the visa for the reason it was intended for, he said. According to Genist, Canada does not want the U.S. to refuse entry to Nigerians but rather screen them more carefully to ensure that they will not migrate to Canada. In essence, Canada wants the U.S. to refuse entry to Nigerians who don't intend to go home, despite the convoluted message their government is sending out. It's a little humorous that the Canadian government is asking the U.S. for help with their Nigerian immigrant epidemic after how they grandstand it as a country that welcomes all immigrants. In my opinion, the liberal morons who run Canada are finding out that there are very real consequences for their idiotic fantasy of open borders. The bottom line is that someone in the government has decided that it's costing too much money, and the burden of such destructive immigration policies is too heavy for their economy. The following is a clip of Canadian government officials providing details to the media about the Nigerian immigrant influx due to their abuse of U.S. tourist visas. I can remember when a lot of these same politicians in Canada were calling Americans racists for wanting to secure our own borders. What a bunch of hypocrites. While I wholeheartedly agree that President Donald Trump should build a wall and completely shut down immigration from several countries which have proven to be high-risk origin points, I think that Canada should sleep in the bed they made until they stop criticizing the United States. What did Canada's leaders think was going to happen after Trump made good on his campaign promise to enforce our immigration laws? The bottom line is that Trudeau and others in their government got caught up in wanting to play the hero and ended up screwing their own citizens. This is another good example of how socialists love to spend other people's money on dangerous policies and then rush to avoid the consequences of their actions. Liberalism is a mental disorder, and Canada should remember this debauchery the next time they elect new leadership.